Hello, and welcome back to Wandering with Wilfred. I am your host, Wilfred, and today we will be wandering through Sweety and Massey Drive, Newfoundland and Labrador. Moose have become a prominent and influential species in Newfoundland and Labrador. Introduced to the island, these animals have significantly impacted the region's ecosystem. Their presence in the area shows their adaptability and importance, as they have shown themselves to be a key player in the local biodiversity and have become a major part of the natural landscape. Moose are the largest members of the deer family. They are primarily found in the northern regions of North America, Europe, and Asia. In North America, they live in dense forests, swamps, and wetlands. These areas provide the moose with access to their primary food sources and the necessary cover to avoid predators. They thrive in cold climates, where their thick, dark brown fur and large nose help them regulate body temperature and filter out impurities from the air. Moose are herbivores with a diet that shifts according to the season. In the spring and summer, they eat a variety of aquatic plants such as water lilies and pondweed, along with tender leaves and shoots from shrubs and trees. During the colder months, their diet transitions to woody vegetation, including the bark of young trees and twigs. Moose are not native to the island. They were introduced in 1878 and 1904. Their presence impacts the local flora and fauna, as they browse on vegetation that other species might rely on. Their role in Newfoundland's ecosystem highlights the complexities and potential consequences of species introduction, both beneficial and challenging, for local biodiversity and habitat balance. If you have liked these videos so far, consider subscribing and sharing with friends and family. Your support helps me in my journey to embark on more adventures. Releasing emotions is a crucial part of maintaining mental and emotional health. When we bottle up our feelings, whether they're sadness, anger, or frustration, they can start to weigh us down and affect our overall well-being. It's important to find healthy ways to express these emotions rather than keeping them inside. For some people, talking to a friend or therapist can be incredibly beneficial. Sharing your thoughts and feelings with someone who listens and understands can provide relief and perspective. Another effective method for releasing emotions is through physical activity. Exercise can be a powerful way to cope with stress and other intense feelings. Activities like running, yoga, or even a brisk walk can help release built-up tension and improve your mood. Physical movement not only helps to clear your mind, but also triggers the release of endorphins, which are natural mood lifters. Journaling is another great tool for processing emotions. Writing down your thoughts and feelings can help you make sense of them and gain insight into what might be causing them. It provides a private space to explore your emotions without judgment. Over time, journaling can also help you identify patterns in your emotional responses and work through complex feelings more effectively. Engaging in creative activities like drawing, painting, or playing music can be a wonderful outlet for emotional expression. These activities allow you to channel your feelings into something tangible and often lead to a sense of accomplishment and release. Creativity offers a unique way to explore and express emotions that might be hard to put into words, helping you process and move through them more smoothly. If you like the video, please give that like button a little paw tap, subscribe for more four-legged adventures, and hit that notification bell so you never miss a future video. Tail wags and happy trails. Embark on the journey with us. Find our images, pins, and postcards. Own these treasures and join our wander. Let's venture together.